mean, I didn't think the film would have been any good when we were working on it, to be honest with you. It was just like a kid's picture. And I don't think anybody on the unit really thought it was any good.
Shooting in Africa with robots in the sand is not anyone's idea of a good time.
Difficulties with the robots led to a loss of time. And in the Star Wars location, where each day could cost upwards of $100,000, the director's affection for his creations had to be tempered with impatience.
I personally, and I think a lot of others at the time, did not have much faith in that as a project. I think people felt that sci-fi films were as dead at the box office as were westerns and musicals. And so when you saw this concept of little robots and furry creatures and a fairly unknown cast, you began to think, well, really, this is all a bit of a waste of time.
This ship carries the crest of Aldrin. With any of the royal family on board? Start tearing this ship apart piece by piece until you find those tapes. Find the passengers of this vessel. I want them alive!
The voice, of course, you don't provide. Do you find it frustrating as an actor not to be performing vocally?
Yes, terribly. I performed all the way through the picture. And I don't think they could do Darth Vader with an English accent. That was the big problem. And also, you see, the character being a big black character that he is. I think George really wanted an obvious black voice, and they've got James Earl Jones in to do it. And to me, there is a very obvious Negro voice.
It's well known that everybody thought we were completely nuts. All the English crew were standing around giggling at a 7'6" man in a dog suit.
What do you mean there's like a 9-foot dog man who wears headphones and is able to make the correct mathematical computations to make the jump to hyperspace? What's that? And still he can only talk in grunts and growls?
Attention. That old man's mad.
You said it, Chewie. Boy, where did you dig up that old fossil?
Ben is a great man.
Yeah, great at getting us into trouble.
I didn't hear you give any ideas.
That old man's mad.
You said it, Chewie. Boy, where did you dig up that old...
That old man's mad.
What? Where the hell have you been? Where have you been?
All right, don't lose your temper. I'll come right back and give you a hand.
Where you going?
To make my report.
Tell him we leave it then.
All right, I'll tell him.
George seemed to be someone who was very unhappy because obviously, you know, you imagine this thing in your mind and then you're seeing it literally put on film, and even we'd always look to him after a take to say, like, you know, and you'd see him go and say, no, let's do it again, but do it better this time.
Cut it.
And.
The mic was in frame.
The mic was in picture.
The mic was in picture.
Everyone back to first position.
A true story, Harrison Ford, who plays the space pirate in the film, at one point threatened to tie George up and make him say his own lines at gunpoint.
I remember saying to George, one day after attempting to say it'll take a few minutes for the Nava computer to calculate the coordinates, that it was easy to type it, but you couldn't say it.
But we can't turn back. Fear is their greatest defense. I doubt if the actual security there is any greater than it was on Aquilaya or Solace. And what there is most likely direct towards a large-scale assault.
You'll never get this bucket of bolts past that blockade.
Well, it's very early in the morning. It's like saying, Betty bought a bit of butter. You know, that those kind of... I mean, your mouth refuses to get around those words.
And then when I opened it and found it was science fiction, I thought, oh, crumbs, you know, this is simply not for me. And then I started reading, and it seemed to me the dialogue was pretty ropey.
Hey! We don't serve their kind here.
What?
Your joints, they left to wait outside. We don't want them here.
He doesn't like you.
Sorry.
I don't like you either.
Sweetheart. Over my dead body.
That is the idea, Solo.
Got it.
Action. Yeah, there was a point when we finished the live action, there was only one special effects shot finished, and they wanted to pull the plug. Just scrap the footage, take a $6.5 million loss, you know, just call it a day. And Alan Ladd and Francis Ford Coppola and people that were supporters of George talked them out of it, and look what happened. I mean, it should be a lesson to all of us that you should believe in what you're doing to the point where you're able to express yourself without constantly looking over your shoulder or trying to change things to make it more like what people expect. Make it the way your heart tells you to make it.
Ah, Star Wars! Nothing but Star Wars! Give me the Star Wars! Don't let them end!
And may the Force go with you!